Students, welcome back to this video. Let us get started our new session with this inspirational quote. Make your life a masterpiece. Imagine no limitations on what you can be, have, or do. Then, topics to be covered in this session are applications of biotechnology in agriculture, and continuation of application of biotechnology in agriculture, that is RNA interference. Then its application in medicine, genetically engineered insulin, gene therapy, and molecular diagnosis. Yes, first we can study about the RNA interference. What do you mean by RNA interference? It is a novel strategy and it is discovered by Matsky in 2001. It is a method of cellular defense. It includes silencing of a specific messenger RNA. As we all know, synthesis of protein from the DNA is necessary for the each character of a living organism. Then, for that, messenger RNA is produced from the DNA so that silencing of the messenger RNA is very important. Protein synthesis includes, or it starts from the DNA. One of the strand of the DNA, messenger RNA is produced. Then messenger RNA transforms to the protein. In between, there are many processes like transcription, transduction, translation, etc. So that process means messenger RNA. If the messenger RNA is silenced, the translation of the messenger RNA into protein is blocked. So that is the basic principle of this RNA interference. Look here. In order to do this process through biotechnology, the introduced gene produces two types of RNA, sense RNA and antisense RNA in the host cell. So two RNAs produces double-stranded RNA. This double-stranded RNA bind to messenger RNA and prevent translation of the messenger RNA of the pathogen. This process mainly done in to create a nematode resistance in tobacco plant. That is done in tobacco plant. This tobacco plant is attacked by a nematode named myeloid gene incognita that infect the root of tobacco plants, causing a reduction in yield. So it can be prevented by RNA interference strategy. RNA interference is a method of cellular defense in all eukaryotes. It prevents translation of a specific messenger RNA, that is silencing due to a complementary double-stranded RNA molecule like that we have studied earlier. Then what is the source of this complementary RNA? That is from an infection by RNA virus or a mobile genetic element. This mobile genetic element, otherwise known as transposons, that is replicated by an RNA intermediate. Here also we require an vectors, so that is an agrobacterium vector. Nematode specific gene or DNA is introduced into host plant. It produces both sense and antisense RNA in host cells. These RNAs are complementary, so they form a double-stranded RNA. It initiates RNA interference and silences the specific messenger RNA of nematode. Thus, the parasite cannot survive in a transgenic host expressing specific interfering RNA. So here, these points are repeated. So what all things are necessary for this RNA interference process? Yes, desired DNA is necessary, that is able to kill the nematode. And there is a vector is necessary, which is known as the vector here, agrobacterium vector. Then similarly, from where this gene is isolated, it is from RNA virus or from the transposons. And these RNAs are complementary to the complementary, so they form a double-stranded RNA, and it initiates RNA interference and silence the specific messenger RNA of nematode. Then next one is applications of biotechnology in medicine. In the medical field, mainly three important aspects it is used. One, to produce various kinds of proteins. Example, genetically engineered engineered insulin, and it is used for gene therapy and also for the diagnosis of a disease, that is known as molecular diagnosis. Recombinant DNA technology helps for the mass production of safe and more effective therapeutic drugs. At present, about 30 recombinant therapeutics have been approved. Of this, 12 are being marketed in India. The three aspects of biotechnological applications in medicine are genetically engineered insulin, gene therapy, and molecular diagnosis. Then at first we are going to study about genetically engineered insulin. Insulin is used to manage adult onset diabetes. Do you know from where this insulin is synthesized or produced in our body? It is produced by the endocrine gland named pancreas. The beta cells of the pancreas produces insulin. What is the function of insulin? That converts excess glucose into glycogen and stores in the liver. Do you know what is the quantity of glucose in blood? That is 70 to 110 milligram per 100 milliliter blood. Whenever it increases, insulin is produced by the beta cells of the pancreas and it converts it into glycogen and store in the liver. Then some cases the glucose level is higher and the insulin is unable to produce and it causes diabetes mellitus. So this is the function of insulin and about the production of insulin. And what is the need to produce insulin through biotechnology? That also we have to see. Insulin from the pancreas of animals, cattle, pigs, etc. causes allergy or other types of reactions to the foreign protein. That is why human insulin is produced by using bacteria through biotechnology. Okay. Then we should know the structure of insulin. It consists of two short polypeptide chains, chain A and chain B. That are linked by disulfide bridges. Then prohormone means insulin, once it is a prohormone, before its maturity, its condition is prohormone. Then when it wants to become a matured insulin, it needs processing. That require processing. So the prohormone contains an extra stretch called the C-peptide. So once it is matured, this is removed during, or it is removed. In 1983, Eli Lilly, an American company, prepared two DNA sequences corresponding A and B chains of human insulin. They were introduced in plasmid of Escherichia coli to produce insulin chains. Chains A and B were combined by creating disulfide bonds to form human insulin. Then second aspect of the biotechnological applications in medicine, that is gene therapy. What is gene therapy? It is a method of correcting a gene defect. So it is a method to correct a gene defect in a child or embryo. Genes are inserted into a person's cells and tissues to treat a hereditary disease. It compensates for the non-functional gene. So this correction method of correction includes deletion, addition, etc. The first clinical gene therapy was given to a 4-year-old girl with adenosine deaminase deficiency, ADA deficiency, that is caused due to deletion of the gene for adenosine deaminase, the enzyme for immune system to function. This adenosine deaminase enzyme is necessary for immune system to function. Treatment by bone marrow transplantation or enzyme replacement therapy, that means injection of ADA, is not completely curative. That is why through the biotechnology it is developed. Then the procedure, how this gene therapy process is undergoing. First, gene therapy for ADA deficiency. Collect lymphocytes from the patient's blood and grow in a culture. Introduce a functional ADA, that is complementary DNA, into lymphocytes using a retroviral vector. They are returned to the patient. This should be periodically repeated as lymphocytes are not immortal. Then if ADA gene from marrow cells, means bone marrow cells, is introduced into cells at early embryonic stage, it could be a permanent cure. Then the third aspect is molecular diagnosis. Molecular diagnosis means diagnose. In order to take the treatment for a disease, the first step is diagnose a disease. So, the diagnose a disease in molecular level. Conventional methods, we know, serum and urine analysis, etc., are undertaking, but they are not suitable for early diagnosis of diseases. In such a case, we have to adopt or we have to use this molecular diagnosis method. It is impossible by techniques like recombinant DNA technology, PCR, and ELISA. Two methods are, one is PCR and other one is ELISA. PCR means polymerase chain reaction. In the lesson principles of biotechnology, you have studied the process of PCR. What are the important steps? Yes, denaturation, annealing, and primer extension. So by adopting this method, we can diagnose a disease. In this pandemic season, the coronavirus is also able to detect by using this PCR technique. So, presence of a pathogen is normally suspected only based on symptoms. By this time, the concentration of pathogen is already very high in the body. However, very low concentration of a bacteria or virus can be detected by amplification of their nucleic acid by PCR. What are the uses of PCR? First one is to detect HIV in suspected AIDS patients, to detect mutations in genes in cancer patients, to identify many other genetic disorders, and we can add one more, to detect coronavirus. A single-stranded DNA or RNA tagged with a radioactive molecule is hybridized to its complementary DNA in a clone of cells. It is followed by detection using autoradiography. The clone having mutated gene will not appear on photographic film because the probe will not have complementarity with the mutated gene. The next one is ELISA. What is ELISA? What is the full form? How do you expand? Enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. What is the principle of this ELISA? ELISA is based on the principle of antigen-antibody interaction. Infection by pathogen can be detected by the presence of antigens, that is proteins, glycoproteins, etc., or by detecting the antibodies synthesized against the pathogens. Okay, students, when we conclude the topic, we have studied RNA interference, applications of biotechnology in medicine. There we have studied genetically engineered insulin, gene therapy, and molecular diagnosis. Then molecular diagnosis, the main two processes we have studied, one is PCR and the other one is ELISA. Okay, students, that's all about today's class. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.